Glass changed my life pretty much instantly as soon as I started melting it for the first time. As soon as I just got those drips going, saw the colors changing, you know, it all just started doing its thing, and you know, it literally gave me a direction to put all my energy in. It gave me a satisfying result of accomplishing something. It gave me a way to support myself. It gave me a way to, you know, just in general, be proud of what I was doing, you know, while doing something in a creative way. But this was finally something I could, you know, completely and totally get lost in. And it wasn't bad. You know, it was like an addiction that didn't hurt me, didn't hurt anybody else. You know, it benefited, if anything. So, you know, I'd say it definitely changed everything about my life.
I love collabs because we're always kind of in a hurry. Whenever people get together to collaborate, in my experience, it's a good opportunity to just hang out with your friends and work, and you don't really have as much time to second guess creative decisions. Usually somebody, you know, there's always a time constraint with collabs, so that causes you to really have to make decisions quickly and just go with it. There's no time to, oh, I'm not sure if I should stick this on the left or the right or up or down. Stick it on so it looks good. Ask your buddies, does it look good? Looks good? Okay, move on. I find that really a really pure creative energy can flow when you don't have that little voice doubting every move.
I think my favorite part of doing collaborations, I guess, would just be the randomness factor. You know, where you're getting together, and you're like, all right, how can we make these, you know, not go together like this, but, you know, work like that, you know, and make it work and, you know, harmonize properly. And then just when it starts all coming together and you see it working, you know, even before before the piece starts actually being built, you know, just in the planning work, sometimes you can start to see everything start to mesh together and, you know, intertwine. And I think that's probably my favorite part. So the colors we used with this piece were North Star's purple lilac, which is a new color. I did say new, right? Okay, gotta make sure I got that in there. And then we had Glass Alchemy's grape, as well as North Star's dark amethyst for the chunks of tubing. We're not necessarily shooting for who makes what. It's all about what looks good on, you know, the project. You know, what works for what the project is at hand. And almost every single time, there's always a, you know, involvement of multiple supplies from multiple companies. You know, they all mesh together. I guess just like a good collaboration, you know. If, you know, they all work together well and it makes a beautiful piece, that's what counts.
I've known Darby's work since basically the beginning of my career. He was one of the stars. Basically, when I first started out, Darby was one of my heroes. I met him here and there over the years at this event or that. My family and I relocated to Southern Oregon around 06 maybe. That's when Darby and I kind of started hanging, started working together, and the homes are a glass institution. So it's, yeah, we've been working pretty tough together for 7-8 years now, whenever we have a chance. When we got together, our first thought was, what can we do that without having to step out of our comfort zone so much? Because we have a time constraint. I like to sculpt females, and Darby likes to sculpt guns, so that was a natural place to start. And I became aware of an artist a few months ago, Kazuki Takamatsu. He's a Japanese artist who works in gouache. It's kind of like watercolor, but little flatter tones. And his images look they look almost like they're designed on a computer, but he actually hand paints them, and they basically involve lots of cutesy little girls and lots of guns. So I showed Darby one particular image that I just thought looked cool. He said, that looks awesome. Let's start by trying to weave that kind of aesthetic. So really, the whole series was inspired by this Kazuki Takamatsu.
my involvement in this collaboration is very sudden. I didn't expect to be a part of it. Banjo and my dad asked me out of nowhere if I wanted to make parts for him. And that was kind of an honor because I have taken part in a piece with them before, and that was by far one of my best pieces I've ever made.
We were able to involve Caleb on this project. We took him on as like a parts worker in a gun facility. You know, you got the guys kind of come in and they got to carve out your bodies for the guns, and the other guys are making some barrels and whatnot. And Caleb kind of jumped in almost like one of our machinists, I would have to say.
Sherlock Holmes basically came in and saved the day. We, like all projects, bit off more than we could chew. And long about halfway through the last day, we had an idea that we liked, but we just didn't have the manpower, the time to really accomplish it. So Sherlock Holmes had to step up, and he came in on one of our little pieces. We needed 6 guns. They're all little, and each one is composed of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Several pieces. So Sherlock Holmes came in at the last minute. Darby and I were busy just trying to get the bulk of the piece ready to put together.
The only thing I ever have a hard time with when it comes to doing a collab is precision. I want to make sure it comes out good. And when I work with Banjo, he's really precise. And the first time I worked with him, I didn't expect anything like at all out of like how precise he was gonna like make me be. And I knew what I was getting into this time, and I was still scared.
Every time I build a project with Banjo, it pretty much goes the same way. You know, it's like, you know, it's real easy and fluent back and forth, you know, decision making on how we're gonna make, what we're gonna make. And then I guess the biggest difference would be like details, intricacy, and time frame. You know, a lot of times we only have like, you know, limited time frame where we can get together, you know, work on something for a minute, and we'll have to leave it aside and, you know, come back to it later. And this one was just beginning to end, you know, and be able to just get everything done, you know, and, you know, the whole way through.
You know, this collab for us, or these three collaborations, probably came off smoother than anything we've ever done. Every time we get together, we say that. This one here, I mean, we really nailed it. We started pushing the pencil around the paper within about 20 minutes. We knew what we were wanting to do, and we hit the ground running. Had virtually no hang-ups the entire time. It couldn't have been any smoother. I mean, we just know each other at this point. We know each other's style. You know, each of us has had a major impact, I think, on the other one in terms of style and the way we go about doing things. So with what we've shared and what we have and brought to the table and combined, we're very much like one entity with four arms at this point. We have a real good ability to get our minds together on an idea, and, you know, it doesn't matter who's doing it. You want to do this? You got it? Got it. And then we just power through. It's awesome.
For this particular project, you know, you turn the lights down, get some cameras out, you know, everything quiets down even a little bit more. And it was just, you know, became really easy to get lost in what we were doing and totally just really, really locked in. I mean, what was it, you know, multiple nights in a row, I'm thinking it's 8 o'clock and it's already midnight, and then all of a sudden it's 2 and 3 in the morning, and I don't know where the time went. But that's a good thing, I figure. You know, we're getting that deep into it, and it's, you know, kind of goes back to, you know, the question of how did glass blowing change my life. you know, it gives me that space I've never been able to achieve before, where I can truly get lost in what I'm doing. Nobody else is there. There's no other worries and issues. And then sometimes I'll like snap out of it, and you know, I gotta look out. Like, is it light out still? Is it dark out? You know, what time is it? How long, you know, who else is in the room even? You know, it just kind of, it all melts away, I guess, the best way to put it. Like with any good plan, you know, you got to jump into it with an open mind, you know, not really stress on numbers, what, how many, you know, maybe your size frame, you know, references something you want to think about. But we really didn't have like a, you know, where we're going to build three pieces. You know, we just kind of, I guess, just jumped right into it as far as like, you know, just planning, and, you know, it just kept going, and get one idea off of one, and you can't really change the whole piece. So, well, might as well start another piece. So I guess this project in particular, for me, I guess it represents, you know, a time frame I get to spend with a friend of mine. You know, the more intense our industry gets, and the broader and bigger it gets, you know, we're all pulled apart in different directions, so many different directions, far away. You know, I think, you know, like over the last few months between me and Banjo, we've pretty much covered almost all the states in this country. You know, so it's like, when do you get to see your friends? It represents that kind of time frame, I guess. You know, when we were kids, we'd go off and skateboard together, you know, and that was that time, you know, and you get that bro time, the hangout time. And now we're all grown up, you know, how do you make that time? It's hard. So I guess that's what this represents for me.
What do these pieces mean? It means that I got to come up and hang out with Darby and his family for a couple days and have fun and make something that we think is beautiful and badass. I had 3.5 years in toward a Bachelor of Fine Arts in sculpture and photography once upon a time, and I, when it came to writing artist statements and describing what my work meant, I never really got good at that part. And one thing I can say about being a glass pipe maker, and a glass, a maker of glass pipe art, you don't have to explain what you're doing. You don't have to come up with some fancy, here's what it is I'm trying to do with my work. But personally, I just want to make badass shit. That's what it means.